Well, here we are at the Grand Isle Beach. Got all kinds of small birds, shorebirds, seagulls, brown pelicans, which is Louisiana state bird, and some friendly people walking by. Always interested in the guy with the camera, or guys with the camera, I should say, because we got Ethan out here today too. We're over here moving in, trying to get some more shots here. See if we can get some more shots. Ain't got much battery left on this GoPro. Trying to sneak in. So foggy out here. A whole bunch of sandpipers and enough of the beach for today. Maybe come back later if there's no birds in the woods. Trying to see what they got out here. So far, so good. It's a nice day. I know my GoPro is about to die too. I got like 1% battery.
I'm going to one side with it.
Last time I was here, they had a box turtle out here.
Yeah.
Yeah, just walking across the trail. Somebody's grave site. Yeah, this is where I saw that black and white warbler up in here. They got some of the prettiest old plantation houses and stuff back here.
Yeah.
Really nice.
Yeah, I think this place is charming. I love all these old homes. Once we got on the Grand Isle.
Dude, they got some, that are like 300.
I can't believe we freaking live down here in one of these places.
They got some that are like 300 years old. And they're all made out of wood, like old,
yeah.
Old stuff.
Well, in fact, they're made out of the old wood, is probably the reason why they're still standing.
Yep. They're like history areas, you know? Uh-huh. Like we go this way, see the roads that way. If we go down this way, they got another, somebody smoking that shit. I can smell it.
There's a lot of pot smoking going on in Grand Isle, huh?
Yeah. That is, that's a starling. They made a nest in the roof. Man, I saw a bunch of fast flying stuff down here. It was like light gray kind of color.
Well, your bird's down there, let's go.
Yeah, look, there's all kinds of birds around here, bro.
Yeah, let's go. Somebody's probably feeding them. I don't think this ain't stupid. I don't know if there's bird feet all around.
Mm-hmm.
There's some birds on the ground right here.
Yep. On the ground.
Uh-huh.
Savannah sparrow.
Yeah, what's that?
On top of the rock. That looks like a pine warblers. Man, if we could hop right back on top of that rock, it's a perfect, Damn, I wasn't even zoomed in all the way. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Oh, yeah. That's cool. We got yellow with a little brown mohawk.
Yeah, that's the one I was just photographing, dude.
Mm-hmm. At least it got some action over here.
Yeah. They might move into the woods later on in the day, but I think all morning long they're feeding.
Yep.
And that fog might have had them, but it stayed in the dust longer or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever they spent the night. Closer to them.
Yeah.
I don't think they're gonna go anywhere.
Yep.
Good job.
They're everywhere though, look.
Yeah, they'll probably come right back. Get up against these bushes maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the white-eyed vireo, dude. You see him?
What?
He's on a little loop of a branch right there. It loops.
Oh, okay.
See him? He just moved. He's hopping around. Oh, he's about that. To come out on the top right there. So just get ready. There you go. See him? He's hopped up there, yeah.
Cool. Very cool.
I know I got a couple of decent ones. They're so fast, dude. It's like. Yeah, that.
Nice.
Yeah, they always tend to go hopping up, so then you just kind of look at a branch that looks like it's in the clear and just try to plan on him jumping on that one.
Uh-huh.
And then you're kind of like a half a second ahead of them, and that helps.
He might be still in there bouncing around somewhere.
Oh, I'm sure. And there's another trail over there where they just went. Because we have to go down this road because it's a dead end on this one.
How many times have you been here now?
I don't know. Five. Maybe.
Beaches, because I'm so used to photographing big birds.
Yeah.
You know, wood ducks, gulls, and larger. Mm-hmm. I looking at these
things. Have like center point focus?
Yeah.
But is it like on one button where you can press and go from group to that?
I have 9-point group, and then over here. My middle finger is where I have single point.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's where I got my single point, the PV button. Yeah, about the street here. Yeah. It's a dead end. He probably got to maybe turn, but you never know.
Busted tree limb looks like a perfect place for him, though. Something to nest in.
I know, huh? I know those starlings are pretty invasive. They probably make nests in almost anything, really. Like the Carolina wrens, they always hit up like plant pots and stuff on people's porches, front porches, the wreaths on their door and stuff like that.
Oh yeah.
Alright, see something back in this tree. They're flying around. Oh, they just took off down there. Probably the same ones we've been chasing. Or we can go down that other track over there if you want.
That's that common yellow throat over there that we hear. I'm hoping it works its way over this way a little closer. I mean, look at this beautiful little area right here, Kirk.
Mm-hmm.
Look at it.
Oh, like perch points.
I know, it's like a perfect place for a bird to hang out. And there's photographers. So like, come here, hang out, get your picture taken.
Yep.
Make you famous.
Hey, I see a little lizard or something on there, huh?
Yeah, I just seen that too, booking real fast. Yep, there it goes. It's something we have playing into our script.
window sticking his gizzard out.
Oh, is he? He's mm-hmm. looking for a girlfriend, ain't he? He's trying to draw the attention of the woman folk. Quieter during the week.
Yeah, I hear like grackles.
Uh-huh.
Or starlings.
They hang out together.
Yeah. Grackles are cool though. You can get some good pictures of them.
Oh yeah, I love grackles.
Those bees sound serious, huh?
Oh yeah. This is another decent spot. You can see some nice perches. Oh yeah, that's not a bee, that's a horse fly. Isn't it? Or a deer fly?
I don't know.
You guys have deer flies down here?
We got horse flies.
Yeah, horse flies. Take my chances petting an 8-foot alligator and get bit by a horsefly again.
Yeah, they just itch, but they make my ankles.
Yeah, it hurts. Common yellow throat. I don't think I'm wondering if putting in my. Like that yellow throat is right over here.
Yeah.
Or do you want to keep walking that way?
Well, where I went, it kind of ended a little bit.
Oh, okay.
They had some pass through there, but they didn't look too wide open, and I don't want, you know, if they got anything bad with your shorts on, I don't want you getting no poison ivy or nothing.
Well, I'm sure I already have it. I thought the trail was...
This little trail will get us to...
We got kind of a yellow throat right there.
Yeah, it's probably sitting in that palm tree.
Oh yeah, because all birds are in palm trees now. Ever since I said the forest was in a palm tree.
Yep, everything's in a palm tree now.
For the whole rest of the day. It's probably in that palm tree.
Probably is. It was in here, huh?
Yeah. It's over there where we just were now.
Look. Did it just fall off?
Yeah, it sure did.
Huh?
It just unscrewed.
I put the rubber one because the metal one makes noise when you sit it down on concrete.
Oh.
Try to be stealth. Really planted some trees. birds in that reed right there.
It's a challenge getting pictures of that, for sure. Little birds.
Mm-hmm. That, like a three-wheeler homemade deal, huh?
Yeah. Hey, it's just sitting there rotting.
Yep, behind the shadow. Take care.